If you're looking to build an AI business in 2025, here's something you need to know. Companies have spent $4.6 billion on AI applications. However, they also spend $8.8 billion on AI consultants trying to actually figure out how to make these AI applications deliver value. So you might be thinking, okay, maybe I should start an AI consulting company, but that's not the real opportunity. The real opportunity is to build AI agents that don't need consultants, that work on their own, that are truly autonomous. In this episode, I'm gonna walk you through 5 AI agent ideas that the market is buying today. And when you implement one of these ideas, it's my true intention, you steal one of these. When you implement one of these, you will be able to excel your path to a successful SaaS business that's riding the AI wave. Intro. What's up, everybody? Welcome to Unstoppable. I'm TK, and on this channel, I help SaaS and AI founders like you grow your businesses faster with an unstoppable strategy. Now, if you're new to this channel, welcome. I drop an episode every single Sunday with actionable strategies and tactics from the trenches on how to grow your business faster. So be sure to hit that subscribe button and that bell icon. That way you'll get notified every single time I drop an episode with the TK energy. Now, if you're already part of this community, welcome back. We just hit 82,000 subscribers. I'm seriously grateful to all of you. Welcome back. All right, now back in my last company, TaoDap, we were a 6-person company right before we raised our Series A. We were a 6-person company, cash flow break even, and doing $1 million in ARR. Back then, it was super efficient and it was actually incredible numbers, which is why we were able to raise our Series A and then our Series B and onwards. Now, fast forward to today, there are founders running $1.2 million businesses with no employees, with a bunch of AI agents. And I'm hearing this story over and over. I've seen the proof of it. So this goes to show that AI agents are clearly the future. We're in the early stages of it. Only a few are really figuring out how to make these work, but when you do, you get incredible impact in the companies that deploy AI technology and AI agents. So in this episode, I've scoured the market to understand what are the big opportunities for AI agents and 5 key AI business ideas that the market is clearly buying today that you can steal and you can actually niche down and you can actually build a successful SaaS company in. So if you're excited to dig in, go ahead and smash that like button for the YouTube algorithm and let's dig right into it. Now, there's one distinction that I came across in my research that I need to preface with these 5 ideas. There's a huge difference between AI workflows and AI agents. And this is something that a lot of times people are really selling you an AI workflow, but they're calling it an agent. The difference, this is something you need to know as you're building and as you're selling and as you're trying to win in the market and differentiate yourself from all the fakers in the market. AI workflows essentially need a human to define a predetermined set of workflow items. It's a bunch of if this, then that, and you stick an LLM in the middle of it. Now, AI agents make decisions autonomously, meaning there's no human needed. You don't have to predefine a certain set of steps. It figures out and gets to an outcome. The market really wants AI agents. AI workflows are cool, but that's why you need a bunch of human consultants to actually deliver on these. They can't make decisions on their own. You have to keep updating the code. So all the ideas I'm gonna give you are actually about AI agents, and that's where the real opportunity is gonna be. All right, so business idea number one, what I'm gonna do is for these 5 ideas, I'm gonna tell you what the category it's in. I'm gonna give you an example, and I'm gonna tell you what metric the business cares about when they're buying it. So the first one, this will be really close to your heart because you're a founder and you're building a real software company, not just trying to sell a template online on an AI workflow, you're trying to build real agents. That's what we're really doing here because that's how we're gonna make the real money. Well, the first one is a software agent. A software agent can plug into your human team and say, hey, you have a certain feature. We're gonna figure out how to reduce the time of that feature being built and being deployed into production. Now, right now you have a lot of copilots. Right now you have vibe coding, but everyone knows you spend enough time in vibe coding, you spend enough time in copilots, you still need the human to figure out how to make it work before you push it to production. And before you push it to production, it's super scary because you now need to understand all the code that it wrote, make sure it didn't break anything. A true software agent, which still doesn't fully exist in the market, but we'll probably get there soon enough, will actually take a feature from your Asana board or your Trello board or whatever it is you're using, your Jira board, or you know, if you're a Basecamp fan, which I am, at some point I think they're coming out with Fizzy where we can track our roadmaps. Well, in any one of those cases, you can take one of those features and give it to the software agent. And without a human interaction, without another engineer spending time on it, it'll say, hey, I'm ready for a code review and you can deploy to production. I've already tested it. That's gonna be the first agent idea. And this is gonna be a multi-billion dollar idea. And I hope some of you steal it and try to implement it. Okay, the second idea. So I'm going to keep moving down the stack from R&D to every aspect of a software business or any sort of B2B business. That's the trick here. Number two is a marketing agent. Now, right now, there are marketing agents. There are agents that will, quote unquote, generate content for you and post online for you. There are agents that will follow up on leads. There's all kinds of agents, but they still are a predetermined set of steps. It's not an intelligent agent that's really figuring out, how do I achieve this outcome? And that's the real business idea. And that's really the billion-dollar idea in this market. And the outcome that you're measured on is how many ICP leads do you generate? So imagine an agent that will figure out, this is my ICP, and I need to generate ICP leads that I can feed to the sales team. And it figures out exactly what channel, who the targets are, and how to engage with them in the best way. That would be a true marketing agent. And remember, going back to my first point, the difference between an AI workflow, which requires a human to set a predefined set of steps and puts an LLM in the middle, versus an AI agent, is that the AI agent can truly take this outcome of ICP leads generated, take the inputs of your ideal customer profile, it can actually figure out your messaging, and it can figure out how to actually participate in the key channels so it generates ICP leads. And you just pay this marketing agent, and it says, cool, thanks a lot, here are your ICP leads. That is gonna be a $1 billion business. Okay, now before I go to number three, number four, and number five, let me pause here for a second. The big opportunity here is to build AI agents that don't require humans and don't require consultants to actually put into production. These are agents that can take an outcome and make decisions and take inputs and actually deliver on those outcomes. That's what makes for a successful agent, and that's what the market wants. That's why they're spending billions of dollars on the software and the premise of the software and billions of dollars on consultants trying to figure out, hey, we really want this because if it works, it's worth billions of dollars to us, so we'll spend a ton of money, but you gotta make it work. And right now, we're still trying to make it work. That's the real promise of agents, and that's why I'm so excited about it. Now, if you're getting value from this, if you're getting excited about agents, be sure to smash that like button for the YouTube algorithm. It just loves it when you do that. Now, I'm not the only one excited about agents. Some of the best technologists, some of the best engineers, some of the best entrepreneurs out there are doubling down on agents. One example is my friend Dharmesh Shah. I've known him for decades, back in the early HubSpot days. I studied HubSpot very carefully and their whole inbound movement when I was starting TeltApp because they had created a category in marketing automation. And we were in the precursors of building the sales engagement category. So there were lots of clues to learn from. So over time, I've stayed in touch with him. So I hit him up because I know he's been super excited about agents. And I asked him like, hey, what makes you so excited about agents? And for those of you that don't know, he actually has an entire bet going. So HubSpot does these next bets. They have certain areas in the market. They're like, hey, this might be the next thing. We're gonna bet on this and we're gonna build something here and see what happens. He has a bet running called agent.ai. It's the professional network for agents. So I wanted to email him and I'm like, hey, what's your thoughts on agents and where do you think it's going? And this is what he shared. And he wrote me a lengthier email and we tried to summarize it. The future will be about hybrid teams of humans and AI agents working together. At agent.ai, we're dreaming big but iterating small, which is what we tell founders to do all the time on this channel. Focusing on delivering value now while building toward a platform for AI apps and agents. And I think it's super powerful because right now you go to LinkedIn and you look for people you can hire to help you solve and deliver on certain outcomes you need for your business. And he's basically saying like, well, you're gonna go to agent.ai and you're gonna buy agents or hire agents or rent agents, whatever it's gonna be called, to achieve certain outcomes in your business. That's the professional networks. It makes a ton of sense. By the way, Dharmesh is super active everywhere on social, but I love following him on LinkedIn. So you can follow him on LinkedIn. He's awesome. And I'm active on LinkedIn too. So you can connect with both of us over there. Now, also, if you're in this stage where you're developing your idea, the one thing that still holds true is you still need distribution. You still need a go-to-market strategy. Whether you're building a traditional SaaS company that's adding AI, or an AI-first SaaS company, or an AI agent company, whatever it is, you still need sales and marketing. And no one has really built the marketing agent that can automate it for you, so it's still on you as a founder. So if you're starting to test these ideas out, if you start to build product, make sure you invest in your go-to-market early on. So to teach you how to actually get distribution and talk about your product and how to sell AI and how to sell SaaS, be sure to grab a copy of my 5-point SaaS growth strategy guide. You don't have to go anywhere right now. It's totally free. I'll link to it below in the description. I'll also link to Hermesh's LinkedIn profile and my LinkedIn profile. Let's get into the rest of the business ideas because this is where it really starts to come together, and I'm going to recap and bring it all together for you. And I also have a bonus item for you that you want to be thinking about. Number three is your sales development agent. So if the marketing agent is generating ICP leads, that's awesome. It'll nurture them, it'll engage with them, it'll bring them into your world. You still need that sales development agent to take those ICP leads and turn them into real demos. And there's still products that are out there that are being promised, like, hey, we're gonna put it in AI SDR, and they'll be able to completely automate your entire pipeline for you. But I have yet to meet a founder or a CEO that came to me and said, hey, it's crushing it for us. Like, I fired my whole SDR team. So we're not fully there yet. But as soon as we are, whichever company figures that out first and really, really delivers, again, on the outcome, on the lead to demo conversion ratio, when it starts to say, hey, we'll take 20%, 30%, 50% of your leads and turn them into demos, we'll figure out where to engage with them and when and what channel in a deterministic way, not a predictable workflow, but like we'll just figure out what they need and where to engage with them, that company's gonna crush it. And this one's really close to my heart because CowDAP was serving sales development reps and VPs of sales were buying us for that. They wanted more pipeline and the sales development reps used our platform, whereas the sales reps use CRM. Well, the thing is, being an SDR is a tough job. This agent would have to look at a certain lead and they'd have to say, cool, where are they hanging out? If they posted on LinkedIn or Twitter, or maybe they did a YouTube video or they commented somewhere, how do I monitor all that? And how do I engage with them in the strategic way? And then how do I email them or call them to follow up on that in the right timing? That's not a workflow. That's not a, hey, just comment here and follow here and call them here. It's thinking about how do I really embrace this person and serve this person? How do I take in the information that they're sharing online and use that to serve them in a better way, to bring them into a sales call? So that is what an agent looks like. It's actually thinking, and there's no human in the loop, and there's no predetermined workflow. That's where this starts to really come together. And that, again, is gonna be another billion-dollar company. Sales engagement is like a $5.5 billion category now. And once the sales development agent comes out, oh my God, the first company to do that, they'll be a billion-dollar company. So it's an incredible business to go after. Number four is your support agent. The support agent has one simple metric. How do I resolve customer issues in near zero time? The more effective you are in resolving customer issues in near zero time, that's your metric. The more effective you are, companies will pay for you. And that's a billion-dollar category right there. And one of my favorite products in the space is Kayeko. They're in my SaaS go-to-market program, and they're incredible. They're building an incredible support agent. It's incredible what these agents can do. These agents are still operating at the level one ticket, maybe the level two, and they're still humans. But over time, the agents are gonna be able to resolve customer issues in near zero time. And when you have that, then you have a multi-billion-dollar category and a multi-billion-dollar company. And that's why I'm particularly excited about the support agent. And then number five is your finance agent. And it's very simple. The metric for the finance agent is to enforce spend and reduce spend. If this agent can just focus and reduce spend, then it'll pay for itself. Every CFO will buy it. And that's the metric they care about. It's like, hey, it's gonna enforce spending budgets, and it's also gonna reduce spend. It's gonna eliminate waste, and it'll pay for itself. And that itself is a billion-dollar category. An event you as a founder would probably pay for that to reduce your burn rate. So those are the five, and we're gonna recap in a second. The bonus one I want you to think about is the agent that's the assistant. Every founder, when they start to raise a Series A or a Series B, definitely by Series B, they hire an executive assistant. That's something that is one of the biggest unlocks for founders. But what if every founder had a founder agent and it knew everything that the founder does, and it is a double check and it can actually own certain outcomes? Maybe it'll own the outcome of creating the board deck 3 weeks before so that you're not working on it the night before, which every founder does. So the bonus one is to think about critical people and creating digital clones of them as agents. And that's something you can be thinking about as well. That's gonna be an incredible business idea and definitely a multi-billion dollar idea. All right, so let's recap. I did this in a logical way because you can start with, even as a founder, think about how you would hire an agent for every single one of the key functions in your company. That's the trick that I used. So that you can be that one person company doing 10 million ARR with a whole bunch of agents. So number one is you would hire a software agent so that you can give it features and it would deploy them into production. Number two is you would have a marketing agent. You give it your ICP and it will generate ICP leads for you. Number three would be the sales development agent. It would take those ICP leads and engage with them and turn them into real demos. You will still have to do the sales calls. I don't know how close by a sales agent is gonna be, or maybe you'll be product led and therefore you won't need sales. So that's something I didn't include. Number four, you can have a support agent. So when customers do have issues, you have near zero time to resolution. And then number five, you would have the finance agent that would monitor all the other agents, all the other spend in the company and reduce the spend. And that way you can continue to be that one CEO that's just managing these agents with a 10 million ARR company. Wouldn't that be cool? Now, you can go after any one of these ideas. And by the way, the bonus one that I gave you is the founder agent. It's a digital twin of the founder, knows everything that the founder does and owns specific outcomes that the founder will have to do later, but it starts drafting early on, which is what a great EA does in a lot of cases as well. And remember, there's a lot of noise in the market. So remember the distinction. There's a difference between AI workflows and AI agents. AI agents truly own outcomes, whereas AI workflows, while they can deliver an outcome, it has to be defined. It has to be an if then else statement with an LLM in the middle. So you want to be able to actually focus on AI agents because that's what the market really wants. And if you can deliver it without the consultants, then you're going to have a multi-billion dollar company. So now you know the five plus the bonus AI agent business ideas. What you may not know is TK, I want to start developing this idea. I want to start marketing it. I want to start validating it. Distribution is something that still has not changed. Whether you're doing a SaaS company, an AI company, a SaaS company adding an AI feature, or an AI company doing a SaaS business model, in any of these cases, you still need a proper go-to-market strategy. So if you're in this stage where you're figuring out your go-to-market, you want to validate the market, you want to scale the business, be sure to grab a copy of my 5-point SaaS growth strategy guide. This is the 2026 edition of our guide. We've added additional content given all the incredible opportunities that exist in the AI space today. And I think that the AI transformation will create a whole bunch of opportunity for founders, especially for driving towards exits, driving towards building meaningful billion-dollar companies. There's gonna be opportunities across different sizes. And so we've updated the 5-point SaaS growth strategy guide for our 2026 edition, and we've added additional content on how to take advantage of AI. So to grab your copy, it's completely free. Just go to getunstoppable.com/strategy. Getunstoppable.com/strategy. You just put in your email and you get access to it right away. Now, if you got value from this video, please smash that like button for the YouTube algorithm if you haven't already. Also, I drop an episode every single Sunday with actionable strategies and tactics from the trenches on how to grow your SaaS business faster and how to grow your AI business faster. So be sure to hit that subscribe button and that bell icon. That way you'll get notified every single time I drop an episode, and also helps us get to 100K subscribers that much faster. And I'm really excited about the trophy we get. We're all excited. Also, we put a lot of love into these videos. So if you have a fellow founder, if you have a team member, if you're part of a Slack group or WhatsApp group of other founders that would get value from this video, please share this with them. It would mean the world to us. We want to help as many founders as possible. And I personally want to partner with all the exciting founders that watch this channel so that I can help you create incredible SaaS companies and AI companies during this platform shift. And lastly, remember, everyone needs a strategy for their life and their business. When you are with us, yours is going to be unstoppable. I'm TK, and I'll see you inside the 5-point SaaS growth strategy guide. Say that 10 times fast or the next episode. Take care, everybody. Okay, with that out of the way, it's going to be really hot. My AC doesn't work here. They're trying to fix it, and it's really hot, and it's Dallas, and it's summertime. Wonderful timing, but we're gonna roll with it.